Now, this is a story, and it's not even tragic, where we all learn that friendship is... Oh, hey, everyone. Scootinator here, back once again for a very special reaction. Now, why do I say very special? Because guess what? The wait is over, and the hype is real. That's right, guys. It's time for me to finally react to My Little Pony Friendship is Magic Season 7 premiere. After 6 long, agonizing months of waiting for new Pwn to come out, well... Here's my reward. I cannot wait to react to it, and, yeah. May as well mention to you, as you guys could tell from the intro, yeah, I've already seen the Fresh Princess of Friendship parody thing, yesterday, actually. I did attempt a reaction to it, mind you. Unfortunately, there were some glitches that pretty much prevented me from, getting it up. So, yeah, sorry about that, but it was awesome, and it made me even more hyped to see this premiere, which I'm very excited about, so can't wait. Okay, first off, my initial thoughts on it. Interestingly, this two-parter is actually the first one to have both episodes be titled separately. Episode 1 is entitled Celestial Advice, which is what I'm heading into. Episode 2 is entitled All Bottled Up. Interesting titles, I think. I did manage to avoid the synopsis, as I will for pretty much all episodes, hopefully, but because of YouTube thumbnails and stuff like that, I am pretty much already aware of characters involved. That is, of course, the main six and Spike. That should be a no-brainer. Starlight. Looks like she's going to be a big focus in this episode. Really should be no surprise considering the finale and stuff like that. Would really like to see more of her character be developed after her strong development in the finale after she overcame her fear of being a leader again. And it looks like we'll also be seeing Sunburst, Trixie as well, which is kind of a surprise, as well as Thorax, Kane Thorax, and the reformed changelings, which that will be pretty interesting to see as well. Hopefully we'll get some sort of backstory for the reformed changelings after the sudden... turn of events in last season's finale. Yeah, I'd love to see, like, the backstory, like, on their current forms and stuff like that and how they came to be. Maybe that was what they were meant to be prior to the forms that we got accustomed to, and then this happened. I'm not even complaining about these new forms. In fact, I actually like them, unlike some others. And maybe this episode will definitely answer some questions that were left unanswered in last season's finale. So I'm looking forward to that. And of course, the princesses, or at least Celestia. I'm really hoping she's a pretty big focus on this episode as well, especially because of the episode title in question, which is Celestial Advice. And because of that, it's making me hope that we get a darn Celestia episode for once. Maybe this will be it. Maybe it'll be focused on her. Maybe it'll be focused on Starlight. I have no idea what to expect at all, because I don't read synopsises, only titles. So yeah, that's enough for me to go off of. Oh yeah, and there's a song apparently at the end of part 2, more than likely, but I'll comment when we get to that, I guess. Last thing I'll mention is, typically I like to know who the writers of each episode are, just for me to specify whether or not, like, is this a good episode or is this just a dud. Like, any of the episodes are duds, but whatever. This episode, luckily, appears to be a pretty good one, because it's written by Joanna Lewis and Christine Sonko, and that's very promising. They've written some really good material for the series for the last 2 seasons. The 2 episodes they wrote in particular for last season, Gauntlet of Fire and Top Bolt, were very good. I enjoyed them both, and they also wrote Legend of Everfree, which I also enjoyed. So yeah, I'm looking forward to what they have in store here. I'm also hoping to know who's the story editor, because it's clearly probably not going to be Josh Haber, unlike last season. I think he's working on a new show or something. Like, if it's Megan McCarthy again, should be no surprise. If they pick somebody brand spanking new, it could be a blessing or a curse. I have no idea. I've pretty much said all there is to say. I'm really hoping I didn't forget anything, because I want to get to this. So, crack open your Cokes, or whatever pops you have in store, or I'm probably the only one drinking something for my reaction, because I gotta have the hype ready. Let's get to it. Episode 1, Celestial Advice, beginning in 3, 2, 1, go. And Starlight.
Hey, Spike. What's up?
Just wanted to make sure you're ready for your big ceremony today.
Yep. Oh, I still what ceremony? Can't believe my friends and I are nice, getting medals teleportation. Of honor.
Are you kidding?
What?
You totally deserve it. After all, you saved Equestria from Queen Chrysalis with the help of Trixie and Thorax and Discord and...
yeah, I know what happened. Yeah. I was kind of there.
Yeah.
So, what are you wearing?
Not sure.
Oh, Spike.
What? Am I supposed to dress up?
No, I mean, you could, It's like Rarity always says. There's no such thing as overdressed. You're just the best looking pony in the room.
Nice. Nice.
What are you looking at?
No, don't look! Because there was a spider there, but it's gone now. So, thanks, Starlight. Bye. Huh?
Okay. Sure.
She had no idea. We're a good team, Sparkle.
Sparkle? Yeah, we are. So, do you think she'll like it? I want this present to say, I'm so proud of you, both as a mentor and a friend. Equestria is safer thanks to you.
Oh, I thought you were getting her a mirror, like yours.
I am.
Maybe you should get her a card, because I don't think the mirror will say all that, but I think she'll like it.
It's just what her mirror needs. The first thing she'll see when she wakes up is herself surrounded by all her friends.
Oh, that would be nice.
I plan on giving it to her after
the
ceremony.
That would be nice, actually.
Yeah, about that. Don't you need to get the castle ready for the celebration?
Nah, Pinkie Pie's got that covered.
Speaking of Pinkie, oh! Yeah, she's got it covered, all right. All right, All right, title. Let's see if they change anything. I doubt it. What friendship could be. Until you all shared its magic with me. Big adventure.
Tons of fun. A beautiful heart, faithful and strong. Mm-hmm. Sharing kindness. It's an easy feat.
All right. Oh, new logo. That's cool.
Starlight, Trixie, Thorax, and Discord were brave in the face of danger.
Oh, they're the new story editors. Okay.
When things got challenging, and proved that the bonds of friendship, no matter how unlikely, are stronger than any adversity. By stopping Queen Chrysalis, not only did they save Equestria, they set the changelings free from her reign.
Go, Discord!
Yahoo! Okay. I actually thought Discord wasn't going to be involved this season,
but...
that's
why we're proud and honored to give them the Equestrian Pink Hearts of Courage.
Ah. That's nice. Somebody new, okay. Clever. Very clever. Almost.
Yay!
Okay then.
We are so proud of you all.
All right, Vinyl, why not? Everyone in Ponyville, okay.
It was the great and powerful Trixie's pleasure to save you from your imminent doom.
Yes, because you did it all by yourself.
I can't believe you managed to do it without magic.
It was amazing. No one's ever stood
okay, so
Chrysalis
they actually
like
do
that.
Have voices after the transformation.
I just did what any pony would have done.
It's a wonderful feeling, isn't it? Watching your student shine the way you always knew they could.
Yes,
my cheeks
absolutely.
Are sore. I don't think I've ever smiled this much in my life.
I can only
those two lines, I think I saw like a little script excerpt a little while ago.
Yes, Starlight is student of the year, isn't she? She has so much potential. So, what are we going to do with her? And by we, I definitely mean you, being her mentor and all that. Her destiny falls squarely on your haunches.
Yeah, whatever.
Oh, don't you worry. I've planned enough friendship lessons to cover the next 3 years. What's so funny?
No. Clearly, Starlight is beyond basic friendship lessons. She just won a medal for Equestria's sake.
Well...
I thought you were joking. You are joking, right?
Of course I was.
Yeah.
Obviously, you should have a grand master plan for her, the same way Celestia set you on a path that eventually made you a princess.
Yep.
Oh, good. I'm sure she can't wait to hear all about it.
So, how's the whole
what is Discord up to?
Kingdom thing going?
It's a bit overwhelming, but we're adjusting.
So you can't have friendship without makeovers?
Not
oh
exactly.
My gosh. Old callbacks, why not?
Princess Twilight has something very important to tell us. Well, just you, really, but I'm nosy and I want to hear.
Okay, would you excuse me? Never mind. What's going on?
Well, Twilight was just about to reveal her grand master plan for you.
Really? I was kind of wondering what we were going to do next.
Yes, I'd say we were both fairly interested.
Of course you are. And I do have a plan, obviously. But now is clearly not the time to do it. You should enjoy your party.
Yeah.
Starlight, come on. The Ponyville Chronicle wants to take our picture.
Oh, you too, Discord.
Ponyville Chronicle. That's new, I think.
I see what you're doing.
Or is it not?
You do?
You already planned the perfect moment during the party to make the grand announcement to every pony about your plan. Twilight, I can't wait to tell Fluttershy and the others.
I don't know that.
Discord, no!
Twilight, are you reading during a party? Again?
No. She's already good at that. She mastered this. She taught me about this one.
Wild guess. Something's wrong.
Spike, I'm a terrible mentor. Why didn't I come up with a path for Starlight? Princess Celestia had it all figured out for me. That's it!
Oh.
I had years worth of friendship lessons ready to go. But when we were captured by Chrysalis, Starlight took charge and really stepped up. I don't think friendship lessons are enough for her anymore.
Ah.
So you have
this'll
an
be good.
Overachieving student. Sounds familiar.
That's why I had to talk to you. You, of all ponies, would know what to do. I mean, you were me and I was Starlight. But for now, I need you to pretend you're you and I'm me.
Huh?
Go on.
When I was your student and you were in this place, you... Oh, no. You sent me to Ponyville, which means it's time for me to send Starlight Glimmer away.
What? Sorry about the jump cut, guys. There were a bunch of glitches going on in the video. I kind of feared those happening. I kind of had a couple plans going, but unfortunately they kind of foiled because there were tons of glitches and I got really frustrated and all that. So I didn't want to spoil the blind reaction for you guys. I didn't necessarily want to end it right there. So hopefully it's going to improve because I'm just going to watch the rest of it on my phone where hopefully there'll be no glitches. Picking up from the second act, just as a reminder, the next 4 minutes or so aren't exactly blind. They're kind of what I got to before I just stopped. But let's get on to that. 3, 2, 1, go.
I can't believe it. It really is time for Starlight to go, isn't it?
Only you can make that decision.
Yes, exactly.
It's a difficult one, but your heart knows what's right, even as it hurts.
Where are you going to send her?
Too soon.
Too soon?
Exactly.
No, this is something I have to do. Oh boy.
Whatever Twilight's planning for Starlight is going to be so exciting.
I swear Discord is such
a... Wonder why she didn't tell any of us about it.
Thane.
Probably because you're not as close as you think you are. Oh, just kidding. She wanted it to be a big surprise. Just between us, she's getting ready to make a big announcement.
You don't know what the announcement
is. That's surprising. Usually you tell your party planner about all your plans for your party. Well, she definitely has one. I mean, when has Twilight not had a plan?
Well, true, but still.
Gosh, I don't know. I just don't want to send her the wrong place. I got it! Since defeating Chrysalis, Starlight's given the changelings an opportunity to revolutionize their society. Maybe I can send her there.
I don't know if I would see her doing that.
Cool spell.
If Starlight goes to the changeling hive,
but...
she can help them adjust to their new way of life. Okay, friendship.
I wouldn't place her in this fantasy.
Thorax and I are going to show you how to compromise.
I want to have honeysuckle nectar for lunch.
I would like a sandwich. Oh no, what should we do?
Attack! The winner gets to choose!
Yeah, okay.
Or Thorax and I can talk about it and come up with a solution that works for every pony.
Starlight, how do you feel about honeysuckle and peanut butter sandwiches?
Why, that sounds delicious! Compromise!
This whole thing's hilarious in hindsight, if that was actually real deal.
This doesn't seem like something Starlight and Thorax would do.
Yeah.
This is Twilight's fantasy, Spike. There is no wrong way to fantasize.
Thank you. Starlight Glimmer.
There are several ways
to
take that sentence.
And perspicacious pony.
Yep, definitely a Twilight fantasy.
This seems like a lovely path for Starlight. The changelings have so much to learn about how to enjoy love through friendships. Starlight would be busy for a very long time, but her work there would be very rewarding.
Or dangerous. It would only take one changeling to deviate from the pack.
And here comes the kind of,
Hi, I'm Starlight Glimmer.
What's the word I'm looking for now?
What's your name? Cornicle?
Conflict.
What kind of name is that? Oh, your so wings many are so, see-through. I'm so glad I'm a pony. Are you like bugs or what?
Well, you gotta admit, that was kind of funny.
There she is! Get her!
Yeah, I gotta say, that would be troublesome.
That probably won't happen.
But it could! I can't just send her off to Celestia knows where without thinking it through!
I was not aware that I was an expression. An appropriate one, of course. For even I don't know the answer. This is a momentous decision. You must consider all the possibilities.
Rethink.
Don't overthink yourself.
What about the dragons? I can send Starlight to the Dragonlands. She and Ember would totally hit it off.
No.
Ember! Starlight!
Nice to see her back, I gotta say that much.
You ready to do some death-defying dragon stuff?
Ha toodle-oo!
Okay, that doesn't sound anything like Ember or Starlight.
No.
Who knows what their dynamic would be, Spike?
Not happening. What the heck?
Freaky.
Starlight will love it in the Dragonlands. In her letters,
Bull.
Ember said dragons do Bull. A lot of fun
not,
things.
Not happening.
The Feast of Fires, the Dragon Bowl, Clawchella. Starlight could be there for a really long time.
Not gonna happen.
And again, not all dragons like ponies as much as Ember does.
Yeah.
Hey, Twinkle Star!
Go away, Garble.
Starlight Glimmer.
Star, Colite, Star?
Starlight, Glimmer.
Yeah, whatever. You wanna hang with us?
What are we diving into?
Lava!
What?
Yeah.
Starlight, this is crazy. Starlight's really good with magic. She could just stop herself from falling into a pit of lava.
Exactly.
But if she didn't realize it was happening! You just never know, Spike! I just need to think of someplace safe to send her.
You're overthinking.
Someplace safe.
Don't send her anywhere.
I could send her to the Crystal Empire to continue her magical studies with Sunburst.
Well, that's a possible alternative, but
Sunburst's knowledge of magic is only matched by Starlight's abilities.
I've got it! Try placing your horn directly on the potion and picture the clock you wish to make.
They could challenge each other into becoming the most talented unicorns Equestria's ever seen. Bird. We did it! Quick, what's next? Of course, the study of magic is a lifelong pursuit, and Starlight could be there for a while, especially once they start attempting the really complicated stuff.
3, 2, 1.
What if they become too ambitious?
I never would have thought to combine Star Swirl's apparition spell with Spatium Flexibus. But what would happen if we added Somnambula's Tempus Objectus?
If we do it just right, it should allow us to materialize an object that was lost in the past.
Oh, don't do it!
Oh, what the heck?
Twilight. It didn't happen.
But it could. I just don't think I can send her anywhere.
Thank you.
What am I gonna do?
What?
Are you laughing at me?
No, I don't think so.
I can't believe you're laughing at me.
Oh, Twilight, I'm not. I'm laughing because I had the exact same fears you're having.
What?
Let me tell you a story.
Oh, this will be interesting.
Once upon a time, there was a very bright young filly. She was truly one of my best students.
Are you talking about Twilight? I can't see what you're thinking about.
Yes, Mike.
Yeah, there was her. Minuets. Moon Dancer, really cute.
I was constantly surprised and impressed with her discoveries. But I noticed that her pursuit of academia was preventing her from reaching her full potential.
You mean it was keeping her isolated and alone?
Yes, Spike.
Yeah.
I had a decision to make. Oh, but it wasn't easy. Maybe I could close the library or throw a party in the castle. Oh, she'd have to talk to the other fillies then. Oh. I must send her away. I knew there was a special group of fillies in Ponyville. But I
think this is what we wanted to see.
All kinds of reasons why I shouldn't send you. What if she runs into a manticore? Or what if she gets pulled into Tartarus?
This is really awesome to see.
What if she doesn't get along with any pony?
Are we supposed to say something?
I don't think so.
I kept you in Canterlot longer than I should have. Eventually, I realized all the anxiety I felt was because I didn't want you to go.
Really?
I loved having you as a student. You challenged me and taught me just as much as I taught you. I am embarrassed to admit it, but I was afraid if you made friends, you wouldn't need me anymore.
Princess Celestia, that is so not true. I will always need you.
I think Starlight Glimmer might feel the same way about you, if that is what you're afraid of.
Maybe it is, just a little.
Oh, it definitely is, like a lot.
Spike,
here
shut
we
up.
Are after all these years, Twilight. We are living proof that letting someone spread their wings doesn't mean you no longer have a place in their lives.
Thank you.
And if you're still worried, you can always make her write you letters.
Sure. That was a really nice moment there. All right.
I may have let it slip that you'd be unveiling your big plan for Starlight tonight. Silly me. But we're all
nice
very
mic,
excited
I gotta say
to
that,
hear what you've cooked up. You weren't coming up with a plan just now, were you? Oh, dear. This could be pretty embarrassing for you.
Gee, why, Discord?
Thanks,
why?
Discord.
Yeah.
Anytime. I really do love being helpful.
If I could have every pony's attention. As you all know, Starlight Glimmer's been my pupil for a while now. And I'd hoped she'd be my pupil for a long time yet to come. But it turns out that's just not meant to be.
Oh, come on.
Starlight,
no.
You have proved yourself to be a kind, loyal, strong, honest, and truly magical friend. Just looking around this room at all the new friendships you've made, I know there's nothing more I need to teach you. So we have a second reason to celebrate today. Three cheers for Starlight Glimmer on her graduation day. The future's in your own hooves now.
Wow, I was not expecting this.
Darn it. I was hoping you'd send her to my realm. We could have been roomies. Way to not pick up what I was putting down.
No. Not gonna happen.
How do you want to celebrate? Girls' trip to Las Pegasus?
We can throw you a changeling gourd fest. It's more fun than it sounds.
Or we could go cause a little mischief. I know a trick that'll turn Celestia's castle into cheese. Do you think it's a gouda idea? That's just the first of many cheese jokes if we go down this path.
Well, that all sounds wonderful. Yeah. But, give me a minute, would ya?
Congratulations.
Thanks. So, how do you feel? Happy? Surprised? Overwhelmed? I mean, not that I'm not grateful, but are you sure?
Believe me, I've thought long and hard about this.
Of course you did.
Starlight, trust me. You're ready.
You sure?
Yeah.
But is she?
No, I'm not.
What are you talking about?
I'm not ready to leave! Oh, good. Because I'm not ready for that either. Here. I got you this present.
It was going to be a congrats on getting a Medal of Honor present, but then I was afraid it would have to be a going away present, but now it's I couldn't be happier stay present. It fits perfectly over your dresser. I know, I measured.
Thank you.
I may not know what comes next for you, but whatever it is, I promise I'll always be there for you.
Oh, oh my goodness. Yes, I... Awesome. It's awesome. Hi, Pinky. Yeah, easy cleanup job. alright. I guess this may or may not be a two-parter after all, but, yeah, I really liked that first episode. It was, pretty heartwarming, I gotta say that. But we still got episode 2 to take care of, and I think we'll be doing that, like, right about now. Or at any second.
Come on!
Cutting right
Turn
to it, okay.
Into a teacup! No! No!
I don't think you're there yet.
No!
Starlight! I can't put a trick that's not working into my act. How come it's not working? It could be because you're just yelling teacup and not picturing it in your mind. Oh.
Yeah, that would kind of help.
That could be it. What does your teacup look like? What shape is it? What color?
Woo!
Starlight! I did it! Hey!
Trixie's so adorable here. I
guess.
I don't know.
You know what you need? A teacup.
No. Well then.
Whoops. I guess I pictured a teacup poodle. Trixie, you ruined my tea cakes. I just got excited. This is the first time I did a transfiguration spell. Real magic. Come on, be impressed by me. Yay, Trixie. You're so great at magic and having good hair. Good job, Trix. But I was baking these to give to Twilight and the girls for their friendship retreat. Pinkie Pie gave me a recipe and everything.
Oh, a retreat, okay.
You need some snacks to give to Twilight?
Where?
I've got you covered. Problem solved.
Oh.
Not exactly.
Cool it. Yeah. All right, title again. interesting start. Interesting that Trixie's learning a little more about things that she hasn't exactly learned yet, such as like transfiguration and stuff like that. Because that's really cool. That's really bonding with her and Starlight's friendship. Also, Trixie's just so freaking adorable here. I gotta say that. She's come a long way, I gotta tell you that much. And so is Starlight, mind you, but still. Alright, let's take a look at this. So I was wrong.
This is not a two-parter. I can't remember the last time we all got to hang out without having to save Equestria.
Well, we are awesome, but technically we weren't the last ponies to save Equestria.
I was speaking in a broader sense. Are you sure you don't want to come with us?
Yeah, I have 3 new comics to get through.
And I promised Trixie we'd practice more magic. It might be better if the castle was empty, if you know what I mean.
Ugh, relax. If anything breaks, Starlight will just go back in time and fix it. Kidding. We'll take good care of the castle while you're gone. Have fun on your friendship retreat.
Well, this is tempting.
What in Equestria is a friendship retreat anyway?
Ah, yeah.
Bon, Sherlock.
And if I know them, they're gonna sing a song.
We are gonna have so much more fun than them.
Yeah, okay.
Twilight, wait! Starlight has something for you.
Huh? Here, I am. Brought you snacks. Oh, how thoughtful. Thanks. We will not get hungry on the train. It was supposed to be tea cakes, but it's a long story.
Yeah.
Have a great time! You too! Okay, Trixie, what kind of spells did you want to work on next?
Well,
a Starlight and Trixie episode. This
magician has a disappearing.
This is really interesting.
So maybe we could start.
I gotta
with
see
that.
This.
Nothing just disappears, so that's technically a teleportation spell, and those are pretty hard. Maybe we should start with something smaller.
No. The great and powerful Trixie goes big or not at all. Just tell me how you do it.
Well, I've always found magic is tied to my emotions. Whatever I'm feeling fuels whatever I'm doing. And the stronger I'm feeling, the stronger the magic.
Right. Like when you were so upset that Cutie Marks took away your friend, your magic was strong enough to enslave an entire village.
Yep. Thanks for bringing that up.
See? I'm already learning.
What does that magic entail? I gotta say that.
Teach me how to do a disappearing spell.
Teleportation spell.
Whatever. I'm complimenting you. And me. We can do this because we're amazing and magic is friendship and stuff.
I guess we can give
She's
it a whirl.
She's got a little bit more to learn, though.
I just need to find you something to teleport.
Spike! How about it? Let's
not
pick
happening.
Something, I don't know, not living.
I mean, it won't be as impressive, but okay. Teach away, Mini Twilight.
Welcome to Manhattan Escapes.
Ooh,
oh,
I'm
Manhattan.
Going to start with a facial,
okay.
And then get my hooves done.
Oh, it's not that kind of retreat.
Isn't it called Manhattan Escapes because it's a deluxe spa where you can escape all of your troubles?
Nope. It's because we get locked in a room and we have to solve puzzles and riddles in order to escape.
Okay, then.
Lead you to a key to get out.
Team building!
Come on, girls. This could be fun.
Could be. Some of the brightest minds in Equestria put together these puzzles.
I'm just happy to be with all of you.
Me too! I'm not great at solving riddles, but I'm super great at cheering other ponies on while they do it.
Return of cheerleader Pinky.
But just so we know, exactly how long will we be locked in here?
A group of griffins set the record for the fastest escape. It only took them an hour.
Griffins barely like each other.
Okay.
We're basically the poster ponies for amazing friendships.
So basically this will take a while for them.
Get your quill ready, bub. You're gonna have to write down a new record.
If you master this spell before the girls get back, you'd be setting some kind of record.
Challenge accepted.
Okay, what you want to do is concentrate on the object that you want to teleport.
Yeah, I'm gonna go.
Yeah, that'd be wise.
Concentrate on teleporting. Got it. Doing the spell.
No, Trix, wait, not just.
Okay, then.
Ugh. Ta-da.
Here comes the conflict. Yeah. This is gonna be interesting.
No. You made Twilight's friendship map disappear.
Him teleport.
Really?
Well, it was behind the apple. It was bound to happen. On the plus side, my magic is getting better. I made a whole table go poof. That was pretty impressive.
Yeah.
Trixie, we
problem.
Have to get that map back.
We'll find it, no big deal.
Twilight's never gonna trust me to be
alone
in this castle again. What were you thinking?
teleport like you told me to.
No, you're supposed to concentrate on the object, not just teleporting.
Well, gee, you probably should have told me all the steps before you let me do the spell.
I tried.
I need a minute.
Hey, are you okay?
I will be, once I cast a spell to contain my anger in this bottle.
Wait, what?
Do you see this storm cloud? This has never happened before! All this magical energy has to go somewhere, and if I'm not using it to fight a magical duel or bend my friend's wills to obey my every command...
Ha! I remember that.
The point is, I don't know what my magic's going to do. So, I'm hoping if I bottle up my anger, I won't do who knows what to Trixie.
Here comes the conflict.
Are you sure that's a good idea?
What choice do I have? I've got to get that map back, and I don't want to lose Trixie. If she knew what I was thinking right now, she'd probably never talk to me again.
Okay.
Well...
You do what you need to do. I'll see if I can find the map somewhere in the castle.
Trixie! Oh, there you are! For a minute, I didn't think you were coming back and that you might be upset with me for some weird reason. But then I remembered, you never get mad at me. Nope, not mad at all. So, the map is probably in the last place you were thinking of. Where was that? Oh, great question! I wish you'd asked it, like, right after I did the spell. I don't remember anymore.
Oh, Trixie.
No worries. We'll just take a walk
this,
around
this
town.
This is totally not a good idea. Jog your memory. I gotta say that.
Okay, that sounds fun. Ooh! Did you remember? Nope. But I did think we could stop for
this
cinnamon
is not gonna last
nuts
long, I gotta
while
say.
We're out. Cinnamon nuts? That's a good idea. Yes! I've been craving something sweet since I couldn't have any tea cakes this morning. You got this, Starlight.
I don't know.
Go, Twilight! You can do it!
Woohoo! Wait! You solved that triangle-y thing mighty fast. Does any pony need a purple jewel?
I wonder if they've been going at it.
Boysenberry.
Don't both those fruits mean purple?
Yes, but one's a lovely purple and one's icky. Just put the gem in! We're trying to set a record here!
What about it?
Yay! We solved another clue! Because our friendship is so true! Yay!
Hello, Kelly's. How can I help you? Oh, are those cinnamon nuts?
Yes. I got them from the cart outside. They're delicious. Do you want some?
Okay.
Have you seen a big table? Magical map on it? Sometimes glowing cutie marks shoot out?
No.
What are you talking about?
Something like that being here.
I cast a pretty amazing spell that transported it to the last place I was thinking of. But I might have been thinking about how I'd treat myself to a nice brooch instead.
No huge table here.
Yeah.
Are you still interested in that brooch?
Sure. No! We don't have time for this. Twilight and the girls are going to be back soon. But I'm not upset. What's our next stop?
Nope, I ain't seen it.
Are you sure? It's really, really important that we find it. And it might be here because some pony was craving apples.
I'm still craving them. They'd go so well with cinnamon
nuts. She has no idea.
Oh, them nuts sure do smell good.
Granny Smith, please. The table?
But, well, my eyes ain't what they used to be, but I know
what table?
A big old table doesn't appear out of thin air.
Yeah. Oh, here's a teacup poodle.
Darn, I could have sworn it'd be at the ice cream parlor because it was warm in the castle and I thought I wanted ice cream. And, oh, maybe we should check out the Crystal Empire because Twilight's castle
Trixie's
is
the new pinky.
I totally had crystals on my
mind.
Oh,
she's Starlight's not having it.
Okay, we better start moving if we want to make it to the Crystal Empire.
Are you okay, Starlight? Because you seem a little... What's the word? No, I am great.
And this is why bottling up your anger is not like... Bottling up your anger is not a good idea.
What's in this?
Oh, hi, Bolt.
Oh, I have had a hankering for these all day.
Ever since that Trixie came by with them.
Oh, crud. Well, things just took a new turn.
Why are they looking at me like that?
This is not good. By bottling up your emotions, it's not.
I'm glad Twilight isn't here to see this. I wish that Starlight was here to see how strong friendships can be when we trust each other and work together.
Son?
You've all taught me so much. Friendship is to make me so queasy, queasy. But you made it all so easy, easy. Now I don't have to say what I'm thinking. You already know without even blinking. You girls are the
that rainbow's like awesome. I had to say that. Nice. Is that a Pony Point of View callback? That's pretty cool.
You know the game isn't over until you turn that key.
Can we do it?
So close.
You missed the Griffin record by 2 seconds.
Probably shouldn't have sung that song.
Yeah. What is this, like the third or fourth consecutive little
thing? You just do whatever you want to do!
Starlight! And you don't always have to bring up my dark past!
I didn't know you had one, Granny Smith.
I'm
just can't believe you sometimes! You make me so mad!
I barely even know you! I don't understand why you're all so mad at me!
They're not. I am.
You are? I'm really mad at you. You lost Twilight's map table. You make jokes like it's no big deal. It's like you don't even care. You could get me in a lot of trouble. If we can't find that table, Twilight's never going to trust me again. And the worst part is, you didn't even say you were sorry!
I'm sorry. I had no idea you felt that way.
Yeah, I do! But to be fair, I don't know how you could have known. I did a spell. Bottled up my anger, but when the bottle broke, it infected these three. I'm really sorry. I used magic, so I wouldn't use magic. I should have guessed that would backfire.
Oh, that's all right. It was a slow day.
Yeah, I was gonna get my dentures clean before y'all showed up.
Oh, no! My God! Yay!
Hang That's on. Nice. Don't you work at the spa?
Ah, I'm late for my other job! What? Who really has?
How many jobs do you run, Bolt?
Hearing you and those random ponies say all those terrible things about me wasn't easy. But I needed to hear it. Why didn't you just tell me how you felt?
I didn't want to lose you as a friend.
Come on. It'd take a lot more than that to lose me. Our friendship is stronger than a few angry words.
And a magical temper tantrum?
Listen, I'd take that over the boring pony you were becoming any day. The Starlight I love is passionate, lively, and yeah, sometimes angry. Those are my favorite parts of you. That, and the fact that you forgive me every time.
I'll forgive you if you forgive me.
Deal.
I remember what I was thinking about.
Oh?
You're kidding me.
There's more to it than that. I was thinking about how glad I am to have met you. And I remembered our first meeting here at the Ponyville Spa. And now I just have to tell you.
Yes.
No, 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 no.
A little to the left. Oh, now rotate it just a hair.
Hey, girls, how'd it go?
Nothing!
What?
Let's just say I learned a friendship lesson while you were gone.
You've barely graduated, and you're already taking initiative. Oh, so proud.
We learned about team building and problem solving.
And when not to sing songs?
We certainly had a good time, but I really was looking forward to a spa day. And the Ponyville Spa is still open. Anyone?
Sounds good to me.
We'll meet you there. Quick, do you have a spell that will make the spa ponies forget that the map table was there?
Haven't you learned anything about using magic to solve your problems?
No. If we learn that lesson, how will we ever have fun?
True. Okay. Okay. That was interesting. I'm going to attempt to give those two episodes a second watch, and I'll be right back, I guess. Alright, so as you can tell by this little change of clothing here, this is a day later. But that's given me enough time to collect my thoughts about both episodes within the 24 hours that I saw them. So, first off, I want to say sorry about picking a really crappy quality copy of the episode for me to react to. There were already glitches going on with my computer, that's why I had to stop in the middle of my reaction, but there's still glitches that are present in the file itself, so obviously, I'm not even the only one to do that. I think almost every reactor who reacted to this episode got the same pretty quality, so apologies for that. But let's get on to my thoughts on both the episodes. First off, of course, I totally thought the whole thing would be a two-parter just with separate titles. Oh boy, was I mistaken. They were just two separate episodes entirely, both written by the same writer, both featuring Starlight, both having maybe a little bit of connection, maybe not
I don't know. Let's go on to my thoughts on celestial advice. First thought I want to bring up are the Pink Hearts of Courage awards that were given to Starlight and Trixie and Thorax and Discord, those guys. Pink Hearts of Courage, I guess they're the equestrian equivalent of the Purple Heart Award in the military. I have no idea if that's really the case, or if they're just the elements of harmony invented by Twilight, which either one could be the case, but who knows, I guess. Also, I actually didn't even expect Discord to appear in this episode at all. I actually thought he wouldn't even appear this season, since I was being informed from John Delancey himself, but I guess you can't believe anyone when it comes to who's gonna appear and who's not. But that doesn't necessarily upset me, especially because Discord kind of plays a big role in the episode. He's the one who causes the main conflict with Twilight as to whether or not she should send Starlight away after she had already graduated from friendship studies. And Twilight's relationship with Celestia is definitely encountered here. Finally, Twilight actually goes to Celestia for some advice, as the title suggests. And Celestia, oh my goodness, she's got an actual personality for once. She actually had a lot of the same fears, tying all the way back to the very first episode of the series, which was very interesting to know. I'm absolutely loving the personality that was being seen in Celestia here. Even though it wasn't necessarily the Celestia episode that we were hoping for, we certainly got to see a lot more Celestia than we've really ever seen in this series, now that I really think about it. However, I'm kind of disappointed we didn't really get a backstory on the reformed changelings or anything like that. Hopefully they'll be doing that at some point during the season, because I really don't want questions unanswered, and I'm sure a lot of you guys don't want those same questions unanswered either. So I guess I'm gonna have to stay tuned for that. Some other features, I guess, are being brought up. Let me check my notes. Twilight's fantasy spell. That was actually pretty cool. A lot of them were definitely pretty cringeworthy, Twilight's fantasies, but they probably could have happened one way or another. Maybe, maybe not. Especially the Crystal Empire. The Dragonland? Definitely not. I wouldn't think so. And as far as the changelings, that would be suitable enough unless one changeling was to drift away from the hive, which is something that is pretty interesting to touch upon. If one of the reformed changelings totally drifts away from the hive, that could be an interesting plot point that I totally would love to see if that ever comes to reality. Also, throughout that, we got a line from Celestia that we'll probably never forget. But moving on, Spike is definitely a prominent feature in this episode as well, being the voice of reason as he usually is to Twilight. And he's actually pretty helpful most times. Other times, well,
oh, it definitely is. Like, a lot.
Shut up!
Additionally, Twilight is once again at her best here. She's basically the quirky OCD Twilight that we know and love, thinking of the worst possible scenarios that could happen within her fantasies. Like, where could I send her? What if this happens while she's there? Or something like that. And yeah, I'm glad to see that side of Twilight again, as I guess we're all used to seeing. And what I especially loved was the bonds between Celestia and Twilight, as well as Twilight and Starlight, displayed throughout this episode. The whole last 3 minutes or so were very heartwarming. Celestia definitely displays how much of a role she has played in Twilight's life. Her fears are definitely realistic here, like Celestia thinking that if Twilight made friends, she wouldn't need her anymore. And of course, that's totally not true. That's very symbolic, I think, of the relationship between a parent and a child, especially with the relationship between Twilight and Starlight, which is amazing. I'm absolutely loving Starlight's character development as time goes on. All of you can say what you want about her, but me, I absolutely love the new Starlight, and I definitely can't wait to see more of her and other characters in the future. But back to the parent-child relationship thing, I think it's very similar to seeing someone's child leave their home for the first time, like for college or something. Of course, that's not me, because I'm actually at my first year in college, but it's like a community college, and no, I'm not like sent away or anything, so I can't necessarily relate to all that, but I know how that feels, definitely. The fear of trying to send someone you love away. And considering the fact that neither of them were ready to depart from each other, that definitely hits at home. I gotta say that. So yeah, overall, the whole episode was amazing. I absolutely enjoyed that one. It definitely ended on a lighthearted note as well, with Pinky bringing out that Teletubby vacuum and cleaning everything up. Yeah, I was 4 and I remember all of that. Don't judge, please. Okay. I don't really have as much to say about the second episode, which is all bottled up. But I still have several thoughts about it. So, yeah, I absolutely love Trixie's portrayal here. Particularly, I guess, towards the beginning. She was really cute here. And the relationship between Trixie and Starlight and their friendship is amazing. It's getting even better as time goes on, just like all of her other relationships. Especially now with Starlight teaching Trixie how to do magic as a proper unicorn and not as a magician. That's really cute. I'm hoping to see more of that. Also, of course, I'd love to know where the teacup poodle happened to run off to. But I guess we'll never know where they went. Because what's the gender? I have no idea. But yeah, Trixie may not have necessarily been at her best here, but I still definitely tolerated her, even though Trixie was pretty much oblivious to Starlight's feelings here. And it definitely gives us a pretty solid moral that probably could have been a lot more subtle, actually, instead of, like, super on the nose. If you just keep bottling up your feelings, it won't just affect you, it will affect others. It can and will. And that's definitely a moral that's very sound. But like I said, Starlight's anger, with it being symbolized by the red puff of magic that is ultimately being bottled up, hence the title, might not have needed to be shown, I guess. But ultimately, that definitely gave us a lot more symbolism on that. So yeah, the whole episode was nice. Great to see appearances from Bulk Biceps as well as Granny Smith. And having those two being possessed by Starlight's anger was actually pretty hilarious to watch. So, as far as the main six's appearance, well, the escape room thingy was pretty clever, I guess. But overall, I'm not sure if they were necessarily needed in this episode, other than fit the main six in somehow. Also, the song was okay at best. Like, it definitely was pretty good, and the visuals are awesome. I know they probably put a lot of effort into that. But as far as the song itself, it sounds like something that totally could have gone on an EQG movie, and I wouldn't have been able to tell the difference. So yeah, that's one, Ingram. I'll forgive you just this one time, but only if you give us, like, much better music throughout the season. If not here, then the movie. Yeah, I guess that's really all I have to say about that. Sorry it's relatively short, but I'm not an analyst, so... Anyways, hope you liked this reaction. Let me know if you did, and I'm looking forward to reacting to more episodes, in the weeks to come. So, yeah, until next time, Scootinator reminding you, there are no wrong ways to fantasize. Am I right, waifu of mine?